not that song.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
FFF episode 905. Hello, it's Mike Matthews broadcasting from Cafe Anyway here at the last place on Earth, located somewhere in Podcastro Valley. Today, the return of the much-loved feature, Matthews News, where we hear some interesting stuff you didn't know about the world of parenting and the internet and a lot of that going on. Plus, we hear from Chely Shoehart, Floyd the Floorman, and John Deere.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
John Deere's a great guy. He helps us out, technically, because he's an engineer.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
So I am going to have a new roommate soon. He comes highly recommended, and I will tell you that that's not very common here in the Bay Area. And Claire de Lune is a song that you hear on the piano, which I can't do. I can't play it. But I can play Phil Collins' In the Air Tonight.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
I sing it like I'm accusing you of drowning some guy.
Mike's.
I saw what you did.
Daily.
I saw it with my own two eyes.
Podcast.
So you can wipe off that grin.
Yeah.
I know where you have been. It's all been a pack of lies. Like a pack of smokes? And if you say the British word for that, do you still get labeled a homophobe? Are all British people homophobes? Because when you say a pack of smokes, it's like not a very nice word towards gay people. And is saying homophobic because it's got the word homo in it? I don't know. Anyway, I got a new roommate. And I got the new Windows 10, which I'm trying to use right now. I've started recording the show 15 times already, and I keep running into problems. Because I'm used to the old system, and I don't. There's all these things now. There's this Cortana, or who I like to call Coriander, and then she helps you with things like where is this, where is that, what have you done to my computer, and she tries to answer you as best she can. And then why does she have to be a woman? Is that kind of sexist to like say like every secretary? Because that's basically what she is a secretary helping you out. Maybe it should have been just not to offend any gender, just sort of made it non-distinguishable. Maybe like a Teletubby voice. That would have been fun. I would do a Teletubby voice for you, but I avoided that show like the plague, and I have not had kids. But I'm impressed with some parents that teach their kids like things, interesting things like about nature. I was walking Basil the Boxer on a trail here in Podcastro Valley. And these two young kids were walking by, and they're like, "Hey, do you want a plum? We picked a bunch of plums off a tree by the trail." And I looked, and they had this huge bucket full of plums, this bowl. And I'm like, what tree? And they're like, "That one down there." I'm like, "You can eat them?" And they're like, "Yeah." I'm like, "Thanks." And I went down, and I picked a plum. It was delicious. Smart kids. They were offering me plums. Just the nicest. I'd like to meet the parents that raise such nice kids. But yeah, that's cool. I like it when parents are teaching their kids new things, not just, this is how you get to the level of this game, War of Warlocks inside of a Game of Thrones thingy with demons and Pac-Man and stuff. That's awesome. But look who just walked in.
Hello, Mike Matthews. It's Chely Shoehart, the kitchen supervisor. Oh, my God. Like, I can't believe you're going to have a new roommate.
Yeah, the last roommate I had was really great. He had a podcast, Marvel at the Movies. I promoted it on my show. He never promoted my podcast on his show, but that's because all his show mattered about was that Marvel. The only art being made in the world was by Marvel. Marvel was the best Marvel. Marvel, all things Marvel. So that's what... but, he's young. He doesn't realize there are other things in this world other than Marvel. He was just Marvelized.
Mike Matthews, I get it. He liked Marvel.
It's what I was... Anyway, but I guess when I was younger, I guess everything to me... What was everything to me when I was young? Gosh. I enjoyed... Star Trek, Next Generation. I used to watch that all the time. Even though now when I watch it, when I see it on the BBC America channel on Saturdays when I'm at work on my Saturday job, I don't remember any of those episodes. And I'm like, oh my gosh. I remember when these effects were so cutting edge for television back in the day. And now I look at it and go, what the... Huh? Oh, cheese.
Mike Matthews, I love cheese.
Yeah. Look who else just walked in.
Oh, my, this is Floyd the Floorman.
And this is John Deere, the engineer. Mike, that's great. You got a new roommate.
Yeah, roommates. So, yeah, he is someone that I've talked to three different references. They're all, like, glowing about him. I met him, seemed very nice. My dog liked him. So I think we're all set. We're all set to go. You've got to have at least three references. You've got to talk to the references. And preferably, it's good if not all three references are family members. That happened with the first guy I rented a room to, and that did not turn out so well. And I'll never forget, I was talking to his mom, and I spoke to his dad, and his mom said a similar thing, even though they're divorced, they don't live together anymore. But the mom said to me, yeah, he's great. He's just so full of talent, and, you know, but you got to stay on him. He'll forget things. And I should have listened to that, because, man, that guy forgot everything. He would leave the oven on. He would turn his shower on, leave the room, and forget about it. The guy is so forgetful. And he wants to be, like, in the medical industry. Can you imagine that? Him, like, operating on you and leaving forceps in your stomach? That would not be good. So it's good, not the same, not family is a good thing. And that if you hear the words, oh, you know, he's smart, but you just need to keep on him about things. Yeah, move on. Because that's going to be a lousy roommate. That's going to be someone you got to say the same thing over. Where's the rent? Where's the over and over again? And you just get tired of repeating yourself. The last guy I had with the podcast, fantastic. Only had to say things maybe once or twice. I think I never had to say anything twice.
Mike Matthews, you just said something twice.
Yeah. Thanks for pointing that out.
You're welcome.
Yeah, so homophobes, homophobic, that whole thing. What'd you think about that line of the song that I was singing about the beginning of the show, when I was talking about that?
Yeah, Mike, I mean, those are words. And what are words for? When no one listens anymore, what are words for?
That was the Motels.
Mike, no, actually, that was the band known as Berlin.
Right, Berlin did that song. What are words for?
Actually, Mike, no. That was the group Missing Persons.
Oh, that's it. Life is so strange. Life is so strange. When you're a stranger, strange. People are strange. Da 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 da. I just mashed up the Doors and Missing Persons.
Mike Matthews, I think you should mention the thing about your website.
Yeah, the website. If you want to comment on any of the stuff you heard about finding roommates, what's your scary roommate story? What do you think of Missing Persons, the Doors, etc.? The Missing Doors, the Motels, and Berlin. Email me, MikeStailyPodcast@gmail.com. You read your comments on the section, emails from email, and your common, not so comments. You can comment on Twitter. I'm at Mike Talks. On Facebook, Facebook.com/MikeStailyPodcast. And go to the website, MikeStailyPodcast.com, with links to where to listen to the show in iTunes. If you go there, make sure to comment on the show there. And if you rate the show, more people find out about us, and we don't languish in obscurity. You can also hear us on YouTube, SoundCloud, TuneIn, Stitcher, Podomatic, Mixcloud, Spreaker, Player FM, and Ameristream Live. And yes, I am on the country radio internet station called Country Crossroads Radio. I'm on their weekends. You can listen to some cool old country and new stuff too. And you can also find us on Instagram, Yelp, and Tumblr. So that's MikeStailyPodcast.com is where to find all those links. If you want to help us out and you buy stuff on Amazon, go through that link on the page there. It's at the bottom if you're on your mobile device, and click on it and buy something at a great discount. Well, sometimes if there's the deal of the day thing there that you can use, and if you buy anything on Amazon, that helps us out if you go through MikeStailyPodcast.com. Or if you'd like to become an inglorious Mike Staily podcasterd, we will send you a special MP3 for thee from a greeting from all of the Cafe Anyway characters. The podcast players will send say hello to you in a special MP3 for thee. The blog, the daily podcast picture, all my past interviews too are at mikesdailypodcast.com.
Matthew's News.
A live version of What's the Matter Here by 10,000 Maniacs about child abuse. This is a form of child abuse that unfortunately has become more popular over the past couple of years. This is according to Time Magazine. Children holding up signs in pictures and video online saying, "I'm a liar and thief. When I grow up, I want to go to prison. I'm on the road to failure. I'm a self-entitled teenager." Sometimes the children are openly crying, sometimes they're silent, sometimes the signs include a defense of the parent. Signs that say, "I'm embarrassed myself. I've embarrassed myself and my mother because she taught me better," said one 13-year-old's sign. Other signs invite participation from passerbys. "I'm a bully, honk if you hate bullies," said one. There are also a growing number of videos of kids with their hair shorn as punishment for anything from bad grades to losing an iPad. One dad asked his son to hold up his failing report card for the camera. The tactic has become so popular in Snellville, Georgia, that a barber specializing in ugly old man haircuts for misbehaving kids is becoming popular. This kind of shaming prompted Illinois State Representative LaShawn K. Ford to propose legislation that would penalize parents who use social media to humiliate, intimidate, or cause emotional distress to their children. Quote, "The internet is forever," says Ford. "These videos could have an effect on a child's whole life, maybe cost them a job someday." Parents found guilty of cyberbullying would pay a fine that would be kept in escrow for the child until they are 18. Ford is also planning town halls with psychologists to discuss the dangers of publicly ridiculing kids. When reporters ask parents or guardians why they've resorted to such tactics, they often say they've tried everything else, and the fear that a child will skid irrevocably off the rails unless a parent does something drastic is as genuine as the anger. Norma Simon, a psychologist and former director of the New Hope Guild Center's training program for child and adolescent therapy in New York City, says some people think these parents are evil, but they're not. They're desperately trying to solve a problem, even if their solution is damaging. And that's the catch. Whether or not you believe shaming a child is wrong, it usually doesn't work as a deterrent, and it has led to suicides. Social media discipline often becomes a solution that creates more problems than it solves. Just ask the dad who shot up his daughter's laptop on camera 3 years ago because of a disrespectful letter she wrote on Facebook. The video has been viewed more than 40 million times, and the angry thing he claims he said in a very low moment will always be viewable by her and her peers and his. Will it go round in circles? Is there sort of a situation of karma going on the internet? Of course, that is Billy Preston, the legendary Billy Preston. And yes, there is something going on the internet. Of course, you heard about the lion, the beautiful lion that was killed this past week when an American dentist named Walter Palmer decided that, well, I want to be a big man and shoot some lion because I read one too many books when I was a kid about I don't know. I don't read books. What would that be? The Ricky Tikki Tavi? Was that about killing lions? No, wait. That was the one with the thing that killed the snakes. That was like a part rodent. Yeah. I saw the cartoon. I didn't read the book. Rudyard Kipling wrote it, though. I know that. Where are we? Oh, yeah. So web users uncovered Walter Palmer's personal information, including about his family, and put it online. They went after his business, a private dental practice, posting thousands of negative reviews on Yelp and other sites. The practice has since shut down, that dental practice. Users also went after a professional website that hosts his profile, leading the sites to remove his information. On Twitter and on his practice's public Facebook page, people made threats of physical violence. This, according to Vox.com, this should look familiar. It is the same set of tactics that has been used in online harassment campaigns such as the Gamergate movement that targeted women in technology, or the seemingly endless online harassment conducted against female journalists. It is a growing trend of internet mob justice, one that often bleeds into real-world harassment with real-world consequences. They talk a lot in this article about Gamergate, but also it's interesting to note that there was a lot of people that had problems with the pizza place that refused to serve gays. Where was that? In St. Louis? Indiana, I mean. And there was a tremendous internet campaign that eventually caused them to lose their business as well. At some point this past Wednesday, somebody taped a sign across the front door of Palmer's now closed dental practice that said, "Rot in Hell." The sign on the closed office was one of many indicators that the online campaign against him has extended beyond a way for people to express their outrage and is now a way for people to punish Palmer directly. In the mold of Gamergate, the campaign has targeted Palmer in two ways: by going after his livelihood and by seeking to inflict psychological suffering in the form of harassment and threats. When Gawker Media ran articles that Gamergate disagreed with, the group responded by going after Gawker's advertisers to scare them into pulling their ads. The idea was to threaten Gawker's ability to pay its employees and thus threaten the livelihoods of those employees. Gamergate also famously blanketed its targets, mostly women, with anonymous threats of physical violence. In April of 2013, shortly after the Boston Marathon bombing, users on Reddit came to believe that a young man named Sunil Tripathi had conducted the attack. Someone who resembled Tripathi had been visible in photos of the marathon, and as it turned out, Tripathi was suspiciously missing. The internet mob turned on Tripathi's family, bombarding it with hundreds of threats. His sister received 58 phone calls just between 3 to 4 a.m. that morning. A few weeks later, the Tripathis, after enduring the trauma of online and real-world harassment, learned that Sunil had in fact died in an apparent suicide sometime before the attack. Reddit users apologized, but it was too late. Internet mob justice. Not only a hard word to say, but also very hard to deal with, because it is definitely not going away. It is part of our world. And the internet was, of course, given to us in a way that it would be a community thing, that it would help us be better as a society. But when a lot of anger is involved and misinformation, it can be a bad thing. And then, of course, people, when they're typing from their computers, what are they doing? They're sitting. They're sitting and they're being active in a way that also allows them to be anonymous. Oh, wait. That sounds like the name of some other sort of internet organization that does their own form of justice on people. At any rate, none of us are happy with that dentist. He was that was just horrible what he did to that lion. But it has awoken another sort of lion of this mob justice thing that we should all keep an eye on. That is some fascinating Matthews news as we go outside of Cafe Anyway, where we bring you Mike's Daily Podcast somewhere in Podcastro Valley at the last place on Earth.
And here's today's podcast picture.
And the podcast picture is some beautiful scenery that I took a picture of. I hope you enjoy that picture there. I don't know what it is yet, but I'll pick it before I post this. You can see it there at MikeSDailyPodcast.com.
Mike Matthews, that's a beautiful picture. I enjoy looking at it. And what I wanted to tell you was that I wish I had a camera.
Yeah, cameras are just so hard to come by these days. They're on everything, Shelley. They're on your freaking phone.
They are? Oh.
Yeah, phones everywhere, the thing. That's why it's important if you have a roommate, if you're looking for a roommate, that you use some form of communication. Phones, text, email. And find out as much as you can about them. And then sing the lyrics to Phil Collins' In the Air Tonight and realize that Phil, in fact, did not mean someone that had drowned. He did not actually see that happen. He just liked the words. He just liked the lyrics. The lyrics just popped into his head, and he liked those chords. And I like those chords too, because I can play them and they're not very complicated. That's why I think I'm going to end the show right now.
Mike, you're not a homophobe.
No.
Then why did you use the word homophobe?
Because I'm not homophobic.
What?
I was saying about the word that the British people use when they're talking about a pack of cigarettes or they're smoking cigarettes. They call them, there's like a word they use, an F word, that's derogatory towards gays.
Oh, I don't like that word.
No.
I'm Floyd the Floorman.
That's great. John Deere, do you want to pipe in with anything?
Yes, I was going to pipe in with the fact that I don't really want to be part of this conversation today.
Okay, go ahead. You have the right to disengage.
Thank you.
Next show, it is going to be the return of the much-loved, the mucho-loved featurette into an interview where I'll talk to a very interesting guest. Plus, we'll hear from Benita, the disgruntled fiddle player, and the brewmaster.
Later that day. Hey. I'm the guy that was talking, Mike was talking about his roommate earlier in the show. I wanted to see that I was a great roommate and I was very responsible and I left the oven on just to sort of prove a point that I can do what I want and nobody can tell me what to do. It's basically what I was a great roommate thing.
Yes, well, okay then. Next show, we will have an intimate evening with Michael Shaw. Yes, that is a band. And it's a band that is going to be performing in San Francisco at the Chapel a week from today. August 7th is when it's going to be happening. We're going to talk to an intimate evening with Michael Shaw, which actually is being promoted by K-Fog, which is one of my favorite radio stations of all time that happens to be in the Bay Area, which happens to be owned by one of my unfavoritest radio corporation owners of all time. But whatever, what are you going to do? Anyway, their cafe, anyway, they're hosting this intimate evening with Michael Shaw, but I get to interview them, him, the band. Well, Michael Shaw. At any rate, that interview will be on the next show.
Mike's Daily Podcast is written and produced and performed by Mike Matthews. His podcast is super easy to find. Download or listen to his show and read his blog at MikeStailyPodcast.com.
Email Mike now at MikeStailyPodcast@gmail.com.
See you tomorrow. Bye.